or the origin of letters. The study of letters or sounds forms a part, a separate stream of study in the traditional knowledge called the Shiksha Shastra or the science of phonetics. So there is an in-depth study of the different sounds which form the part of the language, their origin, their classification, and so on. So how are sounds produced? So there's a shloka which explains this. Atma buddhya samethyarthan mano yunte vivakshaya manakkaya agnimahanti saprerayati marutam. Sodirno murthyabhyato vaktramapadya marutha varnan janayate. Atma buddhya samethya, the atman, so it unites with the buddhi, the intellect, and mano yunkte vivakshaya, it makes the mind want to speak. Vivaksha is the intention to speak. Manaha kayatni mahanti, so the manaha, manas, it stimulates the kayagni, the internal fire. Saprerayati marutam, which in turn generates the wind. Sodirno murdhyabhihato, so the wind or the air, it rises up and it reaches the skeleton, the murdham. Vaktram apadya, and then entering the mouth, varnan janayate, it produces the sounds. So that is the process of generation of sounds. So there is a vast variety or the array of sounds which can be produced by the human vocal cords. So they are produced by different processes. So there are different ways in which the air is pushed out. So that whole process is studied there. So there are two factors which are considered when we are considering the origin of letters. One is called sthana and the other is called the prayatna. So letters, all sounds are produced by with the help of the tongue. So the tongue acts as a karana or instrument, and the tongue touches the different parts of the mouth, helping the pronunciation of different letters. So that part of the mouth which is involved with the tongue to produce letters is called the sthana, varnotpatti sthana, the place of origin of the letter. So this sthana is different for different letters. So there are a series of letters which are produced from a particular sthana. So of those, the first sthana is called the kantha, the throat or the vocal cords. So the air coming out of the vocal cords. So there are three letters which are produced there, which is which are called akara, a, ha, and the visarga. So these three are the letters which are produced directly from the throat without any effort from the tongue. So they are called the kantha sthanas. The letters of the kavarga are produced at the base of the tongue. Jihvamule kuhproktaha. So the base of the tongue, the letters produced are the kavarga letters. Ka, kha, ga, gha, na. And then coming above, you have the roof of the mouth. So the roof of the mouth is divided into two parts. It is called the talu and the murtha. The behind portion of the roof of the mouth is called the talu, and the front portion is called the murtha. So in the talu, the palate, we have the origin of letters of chavarga. Ch, ch, j, j, nya, as also e, and then sh. So these letters are all produced from the talu. Ichu yashanam talu, ikara, chavarga letters, y and sh. The sh used in Shankara or Shiva. So those are produced from the talu. So the tongue raises up and the mid portion of the tongue touches the talu in the production of these letters. The next sthana is called the murtha, the front portion of the roof of the mouth. It is called the hard palate. So ta, tha, da, dha, na, r, ra, repha, and sha, the sha of shanmukha. These are the letters which are produced from the murtha. R to rashanam murtha. So for these letters, the tongue curls backwards and hits the murtha. The tip of the tongue hits the murtha. So these letters are called the cerebrals, the R to R and Sh. The danta, the teeth. So the teeth, two rows of teeth touching together, they produce the letters T, Th, D, Dh, N, the letters of Tavarga, L, the vowel Lkara, the consonant L, and S, Litu Lasanam Dantaha. So these letters are produced by the two rows of teeth touching each other. And then the oshtha, the lips. The lips come together to produce the letters U, Pa, Pha, Ba, Dha, Ma, and the Upadhvaniya, which is the Pa, Antahpuram. The Ah sound is called Upadhvaniya. So U, Pu, Upadhvaniyanam, Oshthau. So these five are the sthanas, the Kantha, and then the base of the tongue, or the Jihvamula. Talu, Murdha, Danta, Oshtha. These are the sthanas. Yamagananam, Nasikacha. For the production of the last letter of each varga, Nyamanana, along with the respective sthana, we have the Nasika, the nose. So the Kantha or the Jihvamula plus Nasika produces Nga. Talu plus Nasika produces Nya. Murdha plus Nasika produces Na. Danta plus Nasika produces Na. And then Oshtha plus Nasika produces Ma. So these five are called Anunasikas. They have the respective sthanas and the nose of the Nasika. Edaitohu Kantha Talu. A and I, these letters are produced with both the Kantha and Talu. Odau Tohu Kanthoshtham. Okara and Aukara are produced with the help of Kantha and Oshtha, the lips and the throat. Vakarasya Dantoshtham. For Vakara, we have the teeth touching the lips. So, Va is a Dantoshtha letter. Jihvamuliyasya Jihvamulam. Jihvamuliya is the half visarga followed by K or K. Kakkhanati. The Akh sound is called Jihvamuliya. It is produced from the base of the tongue. Nasika Anuswarasya. The Anuswara is a pure nasal sound, which does not require any part of the mouth. So these are the origin of letters. Require the prayatna. So the sthana is one factor which differentiates the letters. The other factor is called prayatna, the effort which is involved in the origin of pronouncing the letters. This prayatna is again of two kinds, abhyantara prayatna and bahya prayatna. So abhyantara is the internal to the mouth, that is within the mouth, the prayatna is called abhyantara, and outside the mouth, that is before the air enters the mouth, in the vocal cords, the prayatna, the effort involved is called bahya prayatna. So the abhyantara prayatna is again of four kinds, called sprishta, Ishat Sprishta, Vivrata and Samrata. So, or rather, according to the Mahabhashya, there are five kinds. So, Sprishta, Ishat Vivrata, Vivrata and Samrata. So, of these, Vivrata means open. Where the mouth is open, the tongue, it does not actually touch any part of the mouth. It just approaches, but it does not touch. So those are called vivrata, the open-throated or the open-mouth sounds. All vowels, the swaras are vivrata. A, a, e, e, u, u. In all these, the tongue approaches the sthana. For example, ee, the tongue approaches the talu but does not actually touch it. So the mouth remains open, the air flows through an open mouth. So that is why the prayatna is called vivrata, open, and swaras are produced through vivrata prayatna. Ishad vivrata, slightly open. So in this, again, the tongue, in vivrata, the mouth is fully open, whereas in ishad vivrata, the opening is less. That is, the tongue approaches the mouth part more closely. So that is called ishad vivrata. So ishad vivrata prayatna is for the ushma letters, that is sh, sh, sa, ha. The four letters are called ishad vivrata. The ishad sprishta, slightly touching, the tongue touches the mouth part slightly, that is called ishad sprishta, which is for the letters y, r, l, v. Sprishta is where the tongue is in complete contact with the sthana, that is for all the vargiya vyanjanas, that is the k, kh, g, gh, ng, ch, ch, j, jh, ny, t, th, d, dh, n, t, th, d, dh, g, and pa, pha, bha, bha, ma. So for these letters, the tongue is in complete contact with the sthana, so it is called sprishta. So sprishta, ishad sprishta, ishad vivrata, and vivrata, these cover all the letters or all the sounds. In addition, there is one prayoga called samvrata, which is only for the hrasva akara during the prayoga. So when we utter any word containing the hrasva akara, like rama, so the a is not pronounced with the completely open mouth as a, it is produced with the mouth being closed, rama. So that prayatna is called samvrata, which is only for hrasva akara. So these five are called the abhyantara prayatnas, that is, they indicate the position of the tongue in relation to the mouth parts, whether the mouth is open or closed, etc. The bahya prayatnas refer to the effort before the air enters the mouth, that is outside the mouth. So we have the vocal cords, the air or the wind comes through the vocal cords. So there are again two positions of the vocal cords called vivara and samvara. So vivara means the vocal cords are open, and samvara means the vocal cords are closed. So when the vocal cords are open, the air passes through easily and there is no vibration of the vocal cords, because the air passes, since they are open, the air passes through easily. So that is called aghosha, absence of vibration, and the sound which is produced, that is a breath. It is as good as a pure breath. That is why it is called a shvasa. So vivara, in the open state of the vocal cords, the air passes through without vibration, and the sound which is produced, that is called shvasa. So this is a set of bahya prayatnas. In the opposite case, when the vocal cords are closed, that is samvara, air passes through forcibly, causing vibration, which is called ghosha. And when there is the vibration, the sound thus produced is called nada. So samvara, nada, ghosha, these three together form a set of bahya prayatnas. Among the vyanjanas, the khar, that is kha, pha, cha, tha, tha, cha, ta, ta, ka, pa, sha, sha, sa, the first and second consonant of each varga, and sha, sha, sa, these have the bahya prayatna called vivara, aghosha, shvasa. That is, they are produced through open vocal cords. The other consonants called hash, which is all the third, fourth and fifth consonants of each varga, and hayavarala, these have samvara, nada, ghosha as the bahya prayatna. That is, they are produced through closed vocal cords, generating a vibration. So there is another pair of bahya prayatna called mahaprana and alpaprana, which refers to the amount of air which is pushed out. So if the amount of air is less, we call it as alpaprana, and if the amount of air is more, it is called mahaprana. So the first, third, fifth letter of each varga and yara, lava, these are called the alpapranas. The second and fourth letter of each varga and Shosha Saha. These are called as Mahapranas. There are also three other Bahya Prayatnas called as Udatta, Anudatta and Swarita. These are used in the pronunciation of vowels or swaras. They can be heard clearly during the Vedic recitations, where the pitch of the swara varies. The mid-pitched swara is called Udatta, the lower pitched is called Anudatta, and the higher pitched swara is called Swarita. So these three Bahya Prayatnas are related to the vowels.